What I did was something that apparently people don't do often, torching off 135 pounds of body fat in a period of 7.5 months after having been fat a majority of my life. Now, I tell this story often. Today, I want to talk about something that you might not expect, and that's preparation. I know you've been fat for a long time. If you're anything like me, I carried fat into my adult years. I was obese for a majority of the time from when I was about 7 or 8 years old. Started in that fat is bad kick. That was the thing back then. And of course, mom always had 20 to 30 pounds to lose. And I was eating what she was eating as a young man, or young child, actually, less than 10 years old. And I started to accumulate body fat, got fatter and fatter. And not realizing, and I'm very thankful that she was able to make my clothes for me. But when you're a fat kid going to school with other kids that have clothes from the store, and you show up, fat kid, clothes that your mom made, the fabric and the styles are based on your mom's approach. And you know what? It was great, but that didn't help. Being fat, also, that didn't help with the bullying that I was able to receive. So, whatever your trauma, the point of today's show is make that preparatory thought. Think about what you're about to do. Are you prepared to drop off 50, 60, 100, 200 pounds? And if you aren't prepared, you might want to start thinking about that success. Now, I understand, the way that it seems to work is you go out there and you think about you already having achieved something. When I was dropping off all of that body fat, it was difficult for me to see because I've been fat for so long. So I didn't know what looking down and being flat in the front was like. I didn't know what it was like to look in a mirror and see myself not carrying all that extra blubber. I mean, I had a 65-inch waist. That's remarkable. It's remarkable the way the skin was able to recover in my 50s. And still, I have my scars of attainment or my graduation trophies. But that is something that I will hold on forever and really appreciate because I remember the pain and the anguish of day-to-day activity when I was plus 135 pounds of fat. Now, I've changed my body quite a bit since then. One of the things that I saw as being important was being able to forgive myself. And I know I say this a lot. When you hate yourself, you go end up in the drive-throughs feeding yourself an overabundance of calories. When you maintain a high level of body fat that is destroying you, you don't like yourself for some reason. Now, is it something that happened in your past? And if it is, there's great therapists out there. There's wonderful people that are able to talk you through these items. And maybe after 50, 60 years of really hardcore therapy, you can get that fixed. Or maybe do what I did. And I know we all have that baggage from the past, but maybe some of that can be put on hold for a little while you love yourself a little bit. Say, I'm going to respect myself enough to go ahead and hold off on these thoughts that I constantly have over time. And these are the sabotaging thoughts, the thoughts that set you up for failure every single time you even start to try to restrict calories or you try to go on a fast or whatever the approach is you're going to try this time that you've tried countless times before. Whatever that approach is, it'll probably work if you just continue. So when you screw it up, when you do mess it up, when you go outside the lines, when you are go to that party you didn't expect, or you're standing around with people and they're trying to tell you to do something and you know you shouldn't because you love yourself, but you do it anyway, you did it. Now move on. Forgive yourself for that and go to that next step. Do not get caught up and do not continue in that path because you will do it again and again. And 3 or 4 weeks later, at another 20 pounds fatter, you'll then decide, God, I can't believe I did this again. And that's the way that I look back, it seemingly forever, till I got into my 50s and something changed. And that key component sounds silly. The key component was really me forgiving myself and moving on after I screwed something up. I found that the more that I did that, the less I did the screwing up part and the better I was on the other end. So I continued having more good days than bad. That brings me to something else. Which time's gonna work for you? I tried to quit smoking God knows how many times. Probably as much as trying to be thin. Trying to quit eating, trying to quit being obese, trying to get in better shape, trying not to have the pain associated with being diabetic, trying to fix all those things. Moving forward, I realized that if I could continue day two and day three, it would be okay. I'll be frank, I don't know why this time worked. I know you hate to hear that. It's kind of cool though, looking back and not really caring why this time worked and other times didn't. I suppose if I could figure out that equation, I would have other people doing the videos for me. However, I might get to that. We might figure this out together. We might find out why this time worked for you. Was it 10 words that I said? Was it something that I mentioned to you that pushed you over the top? Was it something that was so insurmountably different, so big, so powerful, you said, you know what, that's it. I'm tired of being fat. I'm tired of this pain I have, name the place. I'm tired of the looks. I'm tired of being uncomfortable in my skin every single moment of every single day. I'm uncomfortable sleeping. I'm uncomfortable going to the bathroom. I'm uncomfortable talking to people. I'm uncomfortable meeting new people. You know what? You've enjoyed the uncomfortableness enough. There's no point in being a little bit more uncomfortable. So you might as well be a little bit more uncomfortable. Stress your stuff out a little bit. Go talk to your doctor, medical professional, and see if maybe not eating for a while could be a solution. And you don't have to not eat for a long time. You can see how it feels. It took me months of preparation before I knew that fasting was my way. I knew that it was superior to cutting my calories. Not eating, I got used to it and I enjoy it and I love not eating. I love being keto when I'm keto. I love eating the sugary treats when I'm doing that, but it's so rare now because I know what happens after I indulge. I know what happens after I drink that alcohol. I know what happens. So I save myself from that pain just like I save myself from other things. Now, being challenged is important as a human being. That helps us grow. That helps us become better. So you could challenge yourself as well. Understand this. People are going to tell you how easy it is, how they did it so stress-free, how they didn't have any pain of loss associated with a dietary change that might equate to them solving their problem. There's going to be a lot of pain. There's going to be a lot of problems. There's going to be a lot of people that are telling you you're doing it the right way. You're going to do your internet searches and you're going to find plenty of people against whatever way you decide that you're going to use to get less fat. And there's going to be a lot of that. I can find people that support the way that I fast, the way that I'm on taking testosterone therapy. I can find a lot of people that are for and against both of those things. I can find people that say it's probably not good to have a bald head and I should probably put some hair on it. I find other people that fill in the blank, don't like tattoos, so on. You got to do this for you. This is important. Ultimate selfishness is really when you would give your time to other people when you're not ready to. That's kind of selfish. When you're not your best foot forward, if you will. Something to prepare for. Your success is going to be yours. I am a person that was fat and got less fat in a period of 7.5 months because I actually realized not eating wasn't going to kill me. In fact, not eating saved me. I'm Connor McIver. Thanks for watching. We'll talk to you in the next one. Be well. Over and out.